Hi there. Today we'll be learning about lipids, a group of organic molecules that we couldn't live without. Imagine a world without olive oil, without butter, and without the cushioning around our bellies that keeps us warm in the winter. A world without lipids is a sad, lean world indeed. So, what exactly are lipids? Well, it's the term we use for a broad group of organic molecules, such as fats, hormones, oils, and some elements of membranes. Lipids are a class of molecules that are hydrophobic and soluble in nonpolar solvents. The most common biological purposes of lipids are to store energy, to provide biological signals, and to help make up cell structures. Let's learn more about them. Lipids are complex hydrocarbons that are predominantly, but not always, nonpolar. Now, nonpolar substances evenly distribute their electrons, and without getting too much into the chemistry, this tends to mean that they're water-insoluble, or hydrophobic. This is why many lipid-based substances, such as olive oil, don't mix with water very well. But it's important to remember that different lipids are made with different components, some of which are individually hydrophilic and some hydrophobic. One category of lipid is triglycerides, and we'll know these types as pretty much all edible fats. They're sequestered in adipose cells as a solid fat that provides a reservoir for organisms to both accumulate energy and provide thermal insulation. Some lipids, such as steroid hormones, act as chemical messengers between cells, organs, and tissues, while others relay signals between biochemical processes inside a cell. The relay of signals is crucial for organisms to function. Think how dangerous, for example, air traffic would be if air traffic controllers didn't relay messages effectively. Other lipids yet form the structure of cells. Different cells and organelles have a thin membrane consisting of two layers of phospholipid molecules. This is known as a phospholipid bilayer. Membranes generally act to isolate cells and sections of cells from their surroundings, which helps to protect the organic components within them from outside risks, while also helping to compartmentalize chemical processes. Without this compartmentalizing, chemical processes could not happen in the controlled way that they do, and life as we know it wouldn't be possible. The lipids that make up the outer layer of these plasma membranes are phospholipids. They're formed as fats that consist of fatty acid chains and are attached to the backbone of sphingosine or glycerol. So we've touched on triglycerides and steroids, but let's now look at some types of lipids and their structures in some more detail. For ease, we'll use the common categorizations, beginning with oils and fats. A fat molecule is made up of two major elements, one or more fatty acids, and glycerol. Glycerol is a three-carbon molecule with a hydroxyl group on each carbon, thus it is an alcohol, or specifically a triol. The number of carbon atoms in the fatty acid can vary, anywhere from 4 to 36, but fatty acids with 12 to 18 carbon atoms are the most common. You'll likely know of wax from coming into contact with it in everyday life, though likely not where it's produced. Wax coats certain marine birds' feathers and some plant leaf surfaces. Waxes are strongly hydrophobic, so they tend to prevent water from binding to the surface of the molecules. They consist of long chains of fatty acids that are esterified into long-chain alcohols. In contrast to phospholipids and fats, which tend to have long, straight-chain structures, steroids have a fused polycyclic structure. Although they're not structured like and don't behave in the same ways as other lipids, they're still classified as lipids because they are hydrophobic or water-insoluble. All steroids have four connected rings, and some, like cholesterol, have a short tail. Most steroids have a hydroxyl group present, which also means they can be classified as alcohols. So we've learned that lipids are primarily used to store energy and relay signals throughout and within cells. You may be wondering then how they differ from carbohydrates. Don't carbohydrates also store energy? Well, the main difference is that carbohydrates are water-soluble, while lipids are not. Carbohydrates, unlike lipids, are able to form polymers, and this, combined with their water solubility, makes carbohydrates great for short-term energy storage, while it makes lipids great for long-term energy storage. So now you're a lipid expert, or at least well on the way to becoming one. We've learned what lipids are, how they're structured, what they do, and some types of common lipids. See you next time.